क्लास टेन मैथमेटिक्स is good afternoon to one and all. Okay, now let me start. Now in this class I am going to start the chapter with the chapter that is arithmetic progression. Okay, we are going to cover the very important questions of this chapter. And I just want you all have to practice these all questions once you attend these classes. Okay. Now, in this arithmetic progression, I hope you may be knowing the formulas which we are using in this chapter. Is this clear? Good. Now here the question can be asked for you, the first very most important question, that is nothing but what is arithmetic progression? That is nothing but what is AP? Okay, so what do you mean by AP? What is AP? An AP is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term. Okay, that is called as AP. So what is AP? An AP is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number in the preceding term, that is called as AP. If we add one fixed number with the previous term, example 2, 4, okay, 4 minus 2 is how much? 2. Okay, now 4, you add 2, what happens? You get next number. Again plus 2, you get next number. I think these are the basics. I hope you all knows about this. I don't want to explain so much about these things, so I hope you understood till here. So this is nothing but AP. I'm not going to concentrate more on this definitions part. Why? Because we have to solve the numericals on this chapter. Before we start the problems, I just want to ensure the basic things which is required in this chapter, which you should be aware of those things. Okay, so what is AP? AP is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number in the preceding term. That is called as AP. Now the differences between these two terms, like 4 minus 2, 6 minus 4, 8 minus 6, okay, this is called as first term, this we call it as second term, this we call it as third term, and this one we call it as fourth term. Okay, so first term, second term, third term, fourth term. If we take the difference between second term with the first term, that is succeeding term with the preceding term, next term with the previous term, next term with the previous term, next term with the previous term, you should get all the numbers constant. That is called as AP. Is this clear? Good. Now AP, where A is the first term, and D is the common difference, and D is nothing but common difference. What is N? N is nothing but number of terms. Okay, now in case if they ask you the question, write the general term of an AP. Okay, next case we are writing general term of an AP only. We are writing the general term of an AP. Sir, already we have done here, then why again? Yes, here the thing is, if we are going to write this from the starting term, okay, if we are writing from the starting, if you write from the starting, then this is the case, this is the formula, an is equals to a plus of n minus 1 into d. It means if you are writing, example, a1, a2, a3, if you are writing from a1, okay, this is my an, this is nothing but my an. So a1 is the first term, a2 is the second term, a3 is the third term, and an is the last term. If you are writing from the first term, then the general term is a plus of n minus 1 into d. In case if you are going to write this from the last term, from which term? From the last term, then what is the general term of an AP? If you are writing from the last term, then what is the general term of an AP? Can you tell me the answer? If you are writing from a1, a2, a3 till an, the general term is an is equals to a plus of n minus 1 into d. In case if you are writing from the last term, like an in the beginning, and then let me say a3, a2, and then a1, then what we get? If you start from the last term, agar se aap last term se start kar rahe ho, to aapka general term ka formula kya hoga? Okay, first term in the start madre a plus of n minus 1 into d, last term in the start madre enagutte formula? What will be the formula? Simple, the formula will becomes an is equals to l plus, l is nothing but last term, that is nothing but last term or an. Okay, l plus n minus 1 into minus d. Is this clear? Then l minus of n minus 1 into d. So this will be your formula. In case if you start from the last term, then the general term formula, nth term formula, will becomes l minus of n minus 1 into d. That is last term an is equals to an is equals to l plus of n minus 1 into minus d. Okay, if you start from the end, so this will be your formula. L is the last term, d is the common difference, and n is the number of terms. Hi Tanzim. Okay, I hope you have copied this part. So this is the important thing which you all should know about these things. Done? Good. Next topic which is important to you, that is norm of an AP, is from the first term or last term? It is from the first term or last term you want?
See here,
for an example, let me take a1, a2, a3, so on, and this is my last term l or an. Okay,
is this clear?
Now what we are doing here, in this case what happens, in this case what happens, we have the formula an is equals to a plus of n minus 1 into d. Got it? Now if in case if I'm going to start from the last term, then l will come first, then who will come for next? a3, then a2, then a1. Now what is the formula we have? An is equals to, in this case what is the first term? What is the first term here we have? L. So I'm going to write L first. Is this clear? I'm going to write L in the beginning. L plus n minus 1. Here, if you want to find d, it was a2 minus a1. This minus this, sorry, in this case, a2 minus a1, a3 minus a2. We are going in the left hand side. Are you getting my point? Now, if you have to take from the last term, then you should take in the right hand side. Here we take, if you go in the left hand side, we take d. But in this case, we are going right hand side, right? Just to remember, the simple logic I can give you. If we take from first term, from starting, you can make it like this. From starting, then it will be d. Same way, if we take from end, it becomes opposite to that, then it becomes minus d. So this will become minus d. Understood? If we take from first, it becomes plus d. In case if you are taking from the end, then it becomes minus d. That's all the difference. Understood? The common difference will become opposite to that. Now what happens here? L minus d is there, right? So minus into plus is minus. Then once if it becomes minus, minus of n minus into plus is minus of n minus 1 into d. Now, did you understood this? Have you understood? Is this clear? The formula? Just minus into plus is minus. I am writing minus here. N minus 1 as it is into d. An is nothing but the nth term. Nth term or general term. An we called as nth term or general term. That's what we are finding, the general term of an AP. Okay, minus into plus, it becomes minus, n minus 1 into d. Now you have understood this? Good. Now, let me solve the next case. The standard form of an AP. If any ICSE students are following this class, even they also can watch this session. But you have to add one more thing, the ICSE syllabus students I'm speaking. Okay, you need to add your geometric progression also. Along with arithmetic progression, you need to solve geometric progression also. Do remember. But AP of Karnataka State Board, CBSE Board and ICSE Board, it remains same. The concepts remains same. Okay. Now, what is the general form of an AP or standard form or general form? We call in both the ways. The standard form of an AP means first we write A1, then we write A2, then we write A3. If you are writing all the numbers in a sequence or in an order till your last term, that is till your nth term, that is called as standard form of an AP. Here A, we write A itself, that is A1, comma A2 can be written as A plus D, A3 can be written as A plus 2D, A3 can be written as A plus 2D, comma till your last term, that is A plus of n minus 1 into D. So this is the standard form of an AP. So this is the standard form of an AP. Is this clear? If you are writing from last term, can you tell me again? What is the standard form of an AP this is from starting, this is from starting, and now this is from end. If you start from end, then how it will be the standard form? See students, this is very important, because while you solve the numericals, if they give you any question to solve in the reverse order, then definitely the standard forms or general terms will be very helpful. Okay, for that reason I'm telling. So what is the standard form of an AP from the end? Then it becomes L. L is nothing but nth term, that is L or AN. Here AN or L, both are same. Okay, L, then L minus D, then L minus 2D, it becomes opposite. L, L minus D, L minus 2D, L minus 3D till A. So here last term is A. In this case, the last term is A. First term is L, last term is A. In this case, first term is A and last term is L. So this is the standard form of an AP if you are in case if you are going to start from the end. So these are the basics you should know. Any doubts? Understood? Good. Next topic, let we solve. Next topic number 5. Now here, if let we say we have one more formula, nth term an can also be written as sum of n terms minus sum of n minus 1 terms. Remember this formula, this will be helpful for you people. Once one question has been asked in the board exam based on this formula, they will give sum of n terms and also they will give sum of n minus 1 terms value, and they will ask you to find the nth term. So you should know this formula, this is very important formula. And then if you want to find common difference, we have formula D is equals to an minus a divided by n minus 1. This is also one formula which we have to find the common difference. To find the common difference, we have the formula D is equals to an minus a by n minus 1. We should know from where we got the, how we got this formula. We got this formula, that is from an is equals to a plus of n minus 1 into d. I want the value of d, so I'm keeping this d as it is. Then what happens? An plus a come this side, it becomes minus a, that is equals to n minus 1 into d. Now I want the value of d, so I'll just cross multiply n minus 1. So it becomes an minus a by n minus 1, that is equals to d. So this is your formula, d is equals to an minus a by n minus 1. Okay, is this clear? Good. Yeah, and one more formula we have, that is D is equals to AP minus AQ divided by P minus Q. We have, this is one more formula which we'll be using to find the common difference. Good. Next, let we solve the topic number 8. Now here, to find the next term, first let we solve this case. Now to find the next term, that is called as succeeding term. Next term is called as succeeding term. To find the next term, we have the formula a n plus 1. Students, remember this is different and this is different. While you are writing, you may do the major mistake. Remember, this is a n plus 1, but this one a n plus 1, this a n plus 1. So while you are writing, you should be very much careful what you are writing. Okay, got it? Good. Now here we are concentrating on a n plus 1. A n means next nth term, plus 1 means next term. So that is a n plus d. To find the next term, we have the formula a n plus 1 equals a n plus d. Similarly, in case if you want to find the previous term, that is called as preceding term. Okay, in case if you want to find the previous term, that is preceding term, then we have the formula a n minus 1. If you want, you can write like this: a n minus 1 is equals to a n, that is nth term, minus d. So these are the two formulas you should know. Got it? A n plus 1 equals a n plus d, and a n minus 1 equals a n minus d. Okay, thank you, Afifa. Okay, now we solve the next topic. Topic number 9. To find the sum of n natural numbers. If you want to find the sum of n natural numbers, then we have the formula Sn is equals to n into n plus 1 by 2. Similarly, to find the sum of n minus 1 natural numbers, then we have the formula Sn minus 1 is equals to n into n minus 1 by 2. So this is the formula to find the sum of n natural numbers, and this is sum of n minus 1 natural numbers. And then topic number 10, to find the sum of n terms, we have the formula, that is Sn is equals to n by 2 into 2a plus of n minus 1 into d. And one more formula we have, Sn is equals to n by 2 into a plus l. L means last term, that is nth term. So these are the formulas which we will be using in this chapter. Okay, good. Now final step, final case we are going to solve now, that is topic number 11. So remember, here this table what I am going to show with you all, this is very helpful while you are solving your 3 mark or 4 mark, if not 5 mark carrying question in this chapter. You should know this table, okay, and even the logic what we are going to use, that is number of terms, term we don't know how many, which are the terms we have to use, and then let we take common difference, that is common difference. Is this clear? Good. In case if you have to find 3 number of terms, they may ask you the question like find the 3 terms, find the 4 terms, find the 5 terms, find the 6 terms, like that you may get a question. Okay, we don't know which are the 3 terms, how to assume which are the 3 terms, or how to assume which are the 4 terms, 5 terms, 6 terms. ओके, आपको क्वेश्चन में कुछ कंडीशन दिया जाएगा, उसके बाद उसमें बताया जाएगा कि आपको 3 टर्म्स फाइंड आउट करना है, ओके, और 4 टर्म्स और 5 टर्म्स और 6 टर्म्स. सो वी हैव टू अज्यूम, वी नीड टू अज्यूम हियर, ओके, वन मिनट, आई थिंक दिस स्पेस इज नॉट सफिशियंट फॉर अस, ओके. Common difference, common difference, and this is the term. If you want to find the 3 terms, then you should take the logic, first a, then A minus D, and then A plus D, left, right. A minus D, A plus D. So we should assume these are the three terms. We have to assume these are the three terms. Anyhow, while we solve the problems, when we solve the problems, at that time I will tell you how to use this. But just now, you have to remember this. Okay, आपको अभी बस इसको याद रखना है. That's it. Okay, ಏನಾದರೂ ನಿಮಗೆ three terms find out ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಾದರೂ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಈ ಲಾಜಿಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. Okay, next four terms if they ask, we should assume the logic A minus D, A plus D, A minus 2D, A plus 2D. Okay, in this case three terms common difference is D. In four terms the common difference is 2D. Understood? If they ask you five terms, then we have the logic A minus D. A is first term, A minus D second term, A plus D third term, A minus 2D fourth term, A plus 2D fifth term. So these are the five terms we have to assume. Here what is the common difference? D. In case if they ask you six terms, then A minus D, A plus D, A minus 2D, A plus 2D, A minus 1 minute, sorry, 1 minute. Let me take. Here I'm going to take, okay, A minus D, A plus D, then A minus 3D, not 2D, A minus 3D, A plus 3D, same way A minus 5D, A plus 5D. Why? Because your common difference is 2D. In this case common difference is 2D. So 1 2 3 4 5 6, so these are the six terms we have to assume. So this is the chart you should remember to solve your 4 mark or 5 mark carrying questions. Okay, so this logic will be very helpful for you all while you solve the problems. Got it? Good. Now let me start. Yes, they will ask in exam. Maximum questions have come on this table only. Till now, if you see the up to date, if you have solved your previous year questions or previous year question papers, you can check it out from this table. Plenty of questions have been asked. Okay. Now let me solve the problems. Now I am going to solve the problems in the form of MCQs. Okay. In the form of MCQs. Few questions I will be solving in the form of MCQs. First question. Take down. The first question. Let me see how fast you people will answer these questions. If A, B and C are in arithmetic progression, are in arithmetic progression, then B minus A by C minus B is equal to dash. Can you tell me what is the answer? Quick. Can you tell me what is the answer? If A, B and C are in AP, then B minus A by C minus B is equal to what? Check. I want the quick reply from you all. Okay, see here, I'll be solving. Now, when can you say the given terms are in AP? It means when we see if the first common difference is equal to the second common difference or is equals to the third common difference, then we say that it is in AP. Agar se saron ke common difference same rahe to hum usko bolte hain AP mein hai. That is A2 minus A1 should be equal to A2 minus A1 should be equal to A3 minus A2. Correct? No. Or it should be equal to a4 minus a3. But right now we don't want a4 minus a3. Let we erase. Let we just take two conditions. D1 is equals to D2. A2 minus A1 should be A, B, C are the three terms. A is the first term, B is the second term, and C is the third term. They have given three terms here. Okay. And they are asking you to find the value of this. B minus A by C minus B value is what they are asking. We know that first term is equals to the second, first common difference is equal to the second common difference. That is A2 minus A1 should be equal to A3 minus A2. Now, according to the given sequence, A, B, C are the three terms. So, A2 minus A1. What is A2? B. Minus A1 is A. Is equals to A3 minus A2. That is C minus B. Now, what we do, I am going to take B minus A as it is. This C minus B, if I cross multiply, it becomes C minus B. Then the remainder is 1. So, B minus A by C minus B, that is equals to 1. So, final answer is 1. Okay. So, this is the final answer. Mohammad Zain. Here no other chats are allowed. In case if you are going to have some other chat irrespective of the subject, then you will be removed from this session. So it's a final warning. Good. Now, the next case, let we solve the next problem. The next problem. 15th term of the AP, 15th term of the AP, x minus 7, comma x minus 2, comma x plus 3, comma ... is dash. 15th term of the AP, x minus 7, x minus 2, x plus 3, so on, is dash. So what is the 15th term? What is the 15th term? Can you tell me? If you want, I'll give you the options. Let me see who may find the correct answer. Option A, x plus 73. Option B, x plus 63. Option C, x plus 83. Option D, x plus 53. Yes, it's okay, Zain. Why? Because it's a YouTube live session, it's going on, it's a live class. So many students will be watching in and around the country. Okay. So what is the 15th term? So here, what is the first term? Here, first term is x minus 7. What is the common difference? A2 minus A1. A2 is x minus 2. Minus A1 is x minus 7. That is equals to x minus 2. Minus into plus is minus x. Minus into minus, plus 7. Plus x minus x get cancelled. 7 minus 2 is 5. So the common difference is 5. Now here the question is, they are asking us to find the 15th term. A15 can also be written as A plus 14D. Okay, what is first term? X minus 7 plus 14 into, what is D? The value of D is 5. Then X minus 7 plus 15 fours are 5 fours are 20, 0 to carry, 5 ones are 5 plus 2 is 7. Okay, X plus 70 minus 7, in 70 if you subtract 7, the remainder is 63. So the final answer is option B, x plus 63. Concept is clear? Good. So this type of questions you will be getting in your final board exam. Okay, these are the types of questions you have to practice. Only in case if you are concentrating only of your textbook sums, that is not sufficient. Remember this. it is not at all sufficient only in case if you are following your textbook based questions. In case if you are feeling your textbook questions only are difficult, then it will be very difficult for you people to cope up with the final paper. So it's a hint which I'm giving to you all. Please kindly cooperate and also practice as number of problems. So definitely it will be helpful for you all. Okay. So the next question, let me take the third question. In an AP, if S5, that is the sum of five terms, that is equals to 35, and S4, that is sum of four terms, is equals to 22, then the fifth term is dash. Then the fifth term is dash. Now, can you tell me the answer for this question? What is the answer? In an AP, if sum of 5 terms is equals to 35 and sum of 4 terms is equals to 22, then what is the answer of the fifth term? How to find? In this question, you can see they have given sum of 5 terms is 35, sum of 4 terms, that is 22, and they are asking you to find A5, that is the fifth term value. How to find the solution for this question? Very simple. As I have suggested you just before, we have the formula, that is an can also be written as sum of n terms minus sum of n minus 1 terms. I hope you remember this formula. Now an is nothing but in n plus what we are writing, a5, correct? No, a5 is equals to s. In place of n we have to write 5, because here we have assumed n is 5. So S5 minus, again S, in place of N write 5 minus 1. Why? Because here if we take 5, in all the places of N, you have to substitute 5. Okay? Good. Now A5 is equals to S5 minus 1. That is nothing but sum of 5 terms minus sum of 5 minus 1 is 4. We know that sum of 5 terms is 35. Minus sum of 4 terms is 22. 35 minus 22. 35 minus 22. 5 minus 2 is 3. 3 minus 2 is 1. So that the fifth term is 13. Okay. See, you have to do the basic calculations. If the questions are objective, minus for your question, I'm just replying. In case if the questions are objective, they will concentrate only on the final solution, only which option you are selecting, they will concentrate only on that. Okay, agar se objective type question hai, MCQs type ka agar se question diya hai, to aapko bas final answer ke upar wo concentrate karenge. They will not see the steps, they will not see the formula, which, where, how you are using. But if the problem is asked in solve, you have to solve the equation or solve the given problem, then formula, substitution, calculation, final answer, everything matters. Why? Because each and every step carries the marks. Okay? So that you should know. Is this clear, child? Good. Hi, Vasia. After a long time. Okay. No problem. Next question, let me solve question number 4. The nth term the nth term of 3, 7, 11, 15 comma and so on is. Can you calculate the answer for this? Yes, what is the answer? The nth term. We know that the nth term an is equals to a plus of n minus 1 into d. A is first term, that is 3, plus n value. Do you know the value of n in this? No, we don't know. How many number of terms? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Till where it's going to stop? Kahan tak wo jaakar stop hoga? We don't know. Correct no? ಎಲ್ಲೋಗಿ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ನಮಗೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿ ಕೆನ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ಎನ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 1, ಡಿ 7 ಮೈನಸ್ 3 ಈಸ್ 4, ದೆನ್ 3 ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇಂಟು ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್, 4 ಇಂಟು ಎನ್ ಈಸ್ 4 ಎನ್, ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಇಂಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್, 4 ಒನ್ಸ್ ಆ 4. ಸೊ 4 ಎನ್, 3 ಮೈನಸ್ 4 ಈಸ್ ಮೈನಸ್ 1. ಸೊ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ the nth term is 4n minus 1. Arithmetic progression, if a4 is equals to 8 and a is equals to 2, then its common difference, is dash. What is the answer? My dear students, kindly cooperate for this class. Okay, just I am hosting this class from a home. So, I hope in the background you people can find some disturbance. Okay, so next classes will be hosting from our studio, from our coaching center. So, most probably you may not find this sort of disturbance. Okay, so here they have given the fourth term. Fourth term is 8, first term is 2. They are asking us to find the common difference. We have the formula an is equals to a plus of n minus 1 into d. In place of an they have given a4, so a4 can be written as a plus 3d. First term is 2 plus 3, common difference we don't know, but a4 value is 8. So 8 plus 2 comes this side, it becomes minus 2, that is equals to 3d. 3d is equals to 8 minus 2 is 6, so d is equals to 6 by 3. 3 ones are 3, 2s are, the final answer of d is 2. The common difference is 2. Is this clear? Good. So my dear students, I hope you people are enjoying these classes. So here we will be solving this type of problems, not only this type of problems, every type, so which is required for your exam as per the requirement of the exam, as how the questions will be asked in the board exam. Based upon that we are solving these questions. Is this clear? Okay, so kindly practice such type of questions so that it is very important for you people to concentrate this type of questions so you can get very good marks. Fine. So now still one important update. Still, if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, Shasar Classes, kindly do subscribe right now and click the bell icon and select all. In case if you have already subscribed to the channel, then no problem. And after the watching this session, this video will be uploaded in our YouTube channel in the live tab. If you go to your, if you are going to watch our channel. In that videos, next to the videos, there will be title live. In that live tab, you can see these recordings will be uploaded soon after the completion of the session. Still, if you have any doubts, again you can rewatch to the same video. Okay, and you can practice. Concept is clear? Good. So now we are going to end up this session here. Again, we'll come up with the next weekend, the next Sunday, and we'll be solving still more number of questions. And we are going to take every chapter important questions in our weekend batches. Again, the next session will be on the next Sunday, but timings will be uploaded in our YouTube post. Okay, in the YouTube post, you can just go to the YouTube community post. In that, we'll be updating you the timings one day earlier about the next class. If not, you can comment in our YouTube channel. We'll update you the timings in case if you are not getting the time. Got it? Thank you so much to attend this class. And it's a free class which has been organized from the Evershine Coaching Center. This is a free class which has been organized from the Evershine Coaching Center. Hope you people have enjoyed these classes. Okay. If you have any doubts, please kindly you can ask me. Do you have any doubts about this class? No? Fine. Thank you. Take care. Wish you all the best of luck.